Hello guys, how are you today? I hope you stay healthy guys, and welcome back to my video. This is my fourth video in this channel. So in the previous videos, I am already told you about introducing myself and my family. I also already told you about my favorite activities during quarantine. And the last video, I am already show you how I do my favorite activities during quarantine. So yeah guys, in this video, I'm gonna tell you about my hometown, such as like the condition of my hometown and the tourism places in here. And also, I'm gonna tell you about how my hometown avoid coronavirus in here. So keep watching guys. And yeah guys, talking about my hometown is in Lovina. Do you know Lovina guys? You know? So Lovina is a famous place in North Bali, especially in Buleleng Regency. Lovina is name of region around Lovina Beach, such as like Kalibukbuk Village, Banyualit Village, Anturan Village, Pemaron Village, and Tukat Mungo Village. So Lovina is located in Kalibukbuk Village. It's around 15 minutes to get Lovina from Singaraja City. Name of Lovina had meaning. Do you know the meaning of Lovina guys? Okay, I'm gonna tell you about the meaning of Lovina. So Lovina is come from two words, love and ina. So love, so the meaning of love is cinta, and ina is mean Indonesia. So the meaning of Lovina is cinta Indonesia. This name is given by Anak Agung Panji Tisna. So guys, if you come to Lovina Beach, you will see statue Lovina with Indonesia flag colors, red on the top and white in the bottom. And talking about Lovina, my hometown is different with the other city in Buleleng Regency. Why? Because I think, in my opinion, Lovina almost look like city, different with almost village in Buleleng. They are quiet. For example, in Sudaji, for example, in the morning, I only saw a few people go out from their house, maybe go to the market or go to work. In Lovina is the same, but the difference is because in Lovina is a lot of supermarket, cafe, bungalows, villa, so a lot of people already go out in the morning to prepare their job. So also a lot of people from not from Lovina come to Lovina to work, because yeah, in Lovina a lot of villa, restaurant and supermarket also in here. So guys, in the morning in Lovina you will see a lot of cars go to Lovina Beach, and inside the cars there are tourists who want to watching dolphin. So the activities in Lovina still busy from morning until midnight. Yeah, until midnight, because like I said before, that in Lovina had a lot of supermarket, restaurant and cafe. So a lot of people and also tourists are spend their time in coffee shop or restaurant or supermarket. Oh yeah, guys, something funny about my village is when I said I'm from Kalibukbuk, no one knows about Kalibukbuk. But after I said I'm from Lovina, everyone will say, "Oh, Lovina." So guys, if you come to my hometown, don't forget to visit Lovina Beach, because a lot of activities, a lot of fun activities that you can do in Lovina Beach. And maybe someday you will visit Lovina, and then you plan to spend your day more than one night, I suggest you to do these activities. At the first, so if you are stay in Lovina more than one night, at the first you have to wake up in the morning around at 4 a.m. and then you go to traditional market and then buy some nasi kuning or jajabali to your breakfast. I know, I think it's too early to get breakfast at 4 a.m. but because after breakfast you have to prepare to jogging. I suggest you to jogging, but if you don't like jogging, maybe you can also cycling, but I prefer jogging to cycling. And if you want to jogging, maybe you can start around 4:30 a.m. until 5 a.m. because you have breakfast at 4 a.m. and then you breakfast around 30 minutes and you start to jogging at 4:30 a.m. So you can jogging to the Lovina Beach by Kartika Street, because in Kartika Street you will find beautiful rice field and also the air in the morning in Kartika Plaza is really really fresh because there are a big rice field there. And the third, after arrive in Lovina Beach, I suggest you to watching dolphin. It's really recommended for you because it's really fun. It will cost around 100 until 150,000 rupees per person to watching dolphin, and around 100,000 rupees for snorkeling. And when you watching dolphin, the fisherman will accompany you to go to the sea by boat. And on the way to go there, you will see beautiful scenery from the sea. Like you can see the beautiful sunrise, and also you can see beautiful hill from the sea. And I had the picture. I had picture when I go to watching dolphin, and I take some picture when the sun rise. Here the picture. What do you think about the picture, guys? Beautiful, right? And by the way, guys, if you go to watching dolphin, you are not directly see the dolphin, but the fisherman will try to find the dolphin and will following them. But guys, if you are not lucky, you only see a few dolphin. But if you are lucky, you will see a lot of dolphin, and also sometimes the dolphin will following your boat. Yeah, it will happen if you are lucky. And hello guys, I'm sorry in this video, in this part is a little bit dark because I'm record in the night. Thank you, I hope you stay enjoy this video. And guys, are you interested to visit Lovina? You don't need to stay at villa or bungalows if you have family or friends around here. Maybe you can stay there. But I'm not allowed you to stay in my house because my bedroom already full. You know, I'm just kidding. And here in Lovina, we had an event held every year. That is Lovina Festival. Lovina Festival usually held on August, and also on that month, usually a lot of cruise ship anchored in Lovina Beach. I hope this August, the Lovina Festival can be held, and I hope the coronavirus goes fast. And not only Lovina, the interesting place in my hometown, there are beautiful rice fields near my house. I usually go there to jogging or to get fresh air. In the previous videos, I already show you the rice field. But if you are forget, this is the videos and photos of rice field near my house.
Indahnya pemandangan banyak loh. Eh, jangan ngomong mas.
Yes, like you seen that photos, you also can see the beautiful sunset from this rice field. Oh yeah guys, in Lovina you can find a lot of art shop beside the beach. The art shop are sells fragrant incense, dream catcher, small statue, bracelet, necklaces, and many others. So if you come to Lovina and want to buy some souvenirs to your family, you can buy in this art shop. And right now guys, I'm gonna tell you about my hometown condition during this quarantine. Like I said before, Lovina is almost like city, not too quiet, not really busy. Before quarantine, the activities in Lovina are conducive, but during quarantine, all activities almost stopped. My hometown applied various rules to avoid coronavirus, such as like traditional market are allowed to open at 8 a.m. and will close at 4 p.m. Oh yeah, not only traditional market, but all market like supermarket also. And in my hometown, the government in my village give the people donation in the form of 15 kilograms of rice, 30 eggs, and money 50,000 rupees. My family got that donation at 4th April 2020 and will get donation again in 2nd May 2020. This donation is very helpful to villagers because almost people in Lovina are work in tourism, and right now a lot of people are stopped working because this quarantine. So the donation from the government in my village is really helpful. And guys, this is the donation that my family got during this quarantine. So this is the 15 kilograms of rice. So this donation is really helpful my family because my parents are stopped working because they are work in tourism. And this is guys the donation that given from government in my hometown. My family got 30 eggs. And yeah guys, I also had a teaser video from event Lovina Festival 2017 I got from YouTube channel Yuk Kebulele. Let's watching. And yeah guys, I also had recommendation about tourism places around my hometown. At the first is Air Panas Banjar, is located in Banjar Village, Buleleng Regency, and it's around 19 kilometers from Singaraja City and take around 32 minutes to get Air Panas Banjar from Singaraja City. And it takes about 17 minutes, around 10 kilometers from my hometown, Lovina. And the second places is Brahma Wihara Arama, is located in Banjar also, near Banjar Hot Spring. It's around 3 kilometers or take about 7 minutes to get Brahma Wihara from Air Panas Banjar. And I will show you the pictures of Air Panas Banjar and also Brahma Wihara Arama here. And that guys, the picture of Air Panas Banjar and also Brahma Arama Wihara. And if you want to go there, don't forget to visit me also. So guys, that's all about my village, about tourism places here, and also what activities you can do in here, and also my hometown conditions during this quarantine. And thank you very much guys for watching my video. I hope you are stay healthy and don't forget to do healthy lifestyle and do exercise every morning, every day. Thank you.